So our first question from Soil4Climate members is, how much drawdown of carbon dioxide into soil is possible in the world?
That's a very important, relevant question, especially on the World Soil Day. We have estimated, along with many other colleagues, the possibility is about 150 to 160 gigatons of carbon cumulative until 2100. So between now and 2100, really about 160 gigatons, which is approximately 75-80 parts per million of CO2 drawdown. Now, this includes all soils, including degraded soil, desertified soil, and so forth. But even if we take the estimate, recent estimates of how much carbon has been depleted from the soil of the world, and that means we can replace that much back, that's about 135 gigatons. So the estimate of the world soil sink capacity for carbon between now and 2100, so next 80 years, is somewhere between 130 to 150 gigatons of carbon, which is a very sizable amount. If you combine this with also what can be sequestered in the vegetation, that's another 150, 160 gigatons. So total put together, we have a possibility of putting carbon in the terrestrial biosphere, soil and vegetation, about 330 gigatons of carbon, which is equal to about 150 to 160 parts per million CO2 drawdown from the atmosphere. This is a great opportunity. Not only that it's a natural process, it's also cost effective, and it has many core benefits. Therefore, it's very important that we support the activity of the Global Soil Partnership and other initiatives that have been started throughout the world, including 4 per 1000, including AAA. And I think this is a thing that we should encourage the policymakers meeting right now in Poland to really discuss, support, and undertake. We should encourage our policymaker that this process of restoring degraded soils and ecosystem, desertified land, is a win-win-win option. It's a bridge to the future. It buys us time until the no-carbon or low-carbon fuel sources take effect. At the same time, it is the best option to achieve the sustainable development goals of ending hunger, ending poverty, improving life on the terrestrial ecosystem, empowering women. Women are the most important farming community in developing countries. So soil carbon sequestration, terrestrial carbon sequestration is something we cannot afford to miss. I would strongly support GSP to follow up on this activity. The last year, the Congress that was held here at FAO headquarters was a very successful event. And I hope similar event can be done.